too much.
Earth, wind, and fire. Let's look at them in the text. Verse 11 and 12 says this. Then he said, go out and stand on the mountain before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind poured into the mountains and broke the rocks into pieces. But the Lord was not in the wind, and out of the wind was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. And out of the earthquake was a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a
so
WEWE. Now finally, look at verse 13. Give me about two more minutes. Verse 13 says, so it was, when Elijah heard it, that he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood in the entrance of the cave. Suddenly a voice came to him and said, what are you doing here, Elijah? In other words, why are you still drinking milk when you should be eating meat? Why are you still in the pews? TMFDC, when all the work is out in the office. Now, no pun intended, y'all. No pun intended. And I know it's Black History Month. But in the church, we have too many house Christians. But what we really need, Madison, are some more steel Christians. You might get that when we eat dinner later. I know times are difficult. It's hard sometimes just to put one foot in front of the other. But there has been no change of power in heaven. Jesus is still on the throne. He still desires to speak to his children and grant us unsurpassing peace. God is ready to deliver you from discouragement. He's ready to deliver you from depression. Listen to his promise. God says in Philippians 4 and 14, and my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Listen to him in Isaiah 26 and 3. He says, if you keep your mind, stay on him. He keeps you in perfect peace. Who are you listening to? Now Psalm 84 and 11 says, no good thing will even hold from those who walk righteously. Philippians 4 verse 10 says that I can do all things, not some things, not a few things, but all things through Christ who strengthens me. Psalm 50 and 15, for those of you who are in trouble right now, right now, blessing. God says, come to me in the day of trouble. I'll hear you. I'll rescue you. I'll deliver you. That you may glorify me. But then the best promise is always the last ones. 1 John 1 and 9 says, if I confess my sins, he's faithful and just to forgive me and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Romans 10 and 9 says, if I confess with my mouth, Lord Jesus, believe in my heart, God raised you from the dead. You shall be saved. I don't care what you're going through, it's going to get better. I don't care what the doctor said, he got the last word. He's still in the prayer answering ministry. He's still able to do exceedingly and abundantly above what you can ask. Think on that. Let us pray. Mighty everlasting God, hear us today, Lord. Master, there are so many people in this church, friends of this church. Lord, some have been diagnosed with cancer. Some are in the hospital right now, but we don't even know what's going on. And then, Lord, there are many in our families who are lost and don't know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Father, I'm praying you to lift up our bowed down heads. Sometimes it's get discouraging when you keep praying for them and you still see them living the same way. But Lord, let us do like Elijah did. Get up, get out, arise, eat, feed on your word. A still small voice that says, I'm with you. I got this under control. Leave it up to me. We're believing by faith, Lord, that you're going to do just it. It is in Jesus Christ's name that we will always pray and always give thanks. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise. With our ministers and deacons and faith counselors, quickly join me.